and always put a link joint at measuring how much is the diameter of the DG in particular child, and then put the axial cable. Because you have to be very cautious in the beginning that neurovascular bundle should not be
outlined.
This way you make a construct on the proximal area with 2 or 3 K wires and the 2 L rods on the medial side, 2 L rods on the lateral side. Connect the medial hold and the lateral hold with the transverse K wire. Yeah. And one posterior on these posterior legs. This is how we make the this proximal construct, and then we put insert 2 K wires in the metatarsal from the medial side as well from the lateral side. You should use 2 half pins on the medial side, 2 half pins on the lateral side. You should not impale all the metatarsals, and respect the arches of the foot. Otherwise, patient will land up with the deformity of leg foot and the arches will be lost. So, 3 K wires on the proximal part of the TBR, 2 K wires medially, 2 K wires laterally on the metatarsal, 2 K wires transfixing the calcaneum, transverse K wires, always take care of the neurovascular bundle on the medial side, posterior tibial artery, always palpate it, and then impale the bone. 1 axial K wire posteriorly here, 1 axial K wire here, 1 axial K wire here to make the calcaneal hold more stable. 1 transverse connecting rod posteriorly. Here 2 straight rods to make the construct on the calcaneum on the medial side, 1 on the lateral side. This metatarsal hold should also be made with the straight connecting rod, but it is better to take the L rod on the metatarsal hold so that you have the leg to connect the anterior TBO metatarsal connection. This is the L rods here. Here it is the straight rod. So 2 L rods here, 1 medially, other laterally. 2 L rods are here. So total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 L rods. And this straight rod, again here straight rod, this straight connecting rod, these are the different connections. And once you have made the constructs on the metatarsal, calcaneum and the proximal part of the tibia, then you connect these holds anteriorly with the connecting rod, anterior TBO metatarsal connection. Posteriorly, you use these 2 distractors, 2 distracts posteriorly, which connect the TBO calcaneal hole. And these distractors are open mouth, so you can always readjust them according to the need. Then 1 medial distractor and other lateral distractor. The knob should be anterior so that you can always distract the medial side and the lateral side by clockwise rotation of the knob. There are 4 numbers on this knob, 1, 2, 3, 4. If you just rotate 90 degrees, you get 0.25 distraction on the medial side. And if you distract the same on the lateral side, it will be same. That's why you have to do distraction on the medial side twice a day, 4 times a day, and on the lateral side twice a day. The distraction on the lateral side should be half than on the medial side. Then you achieve differential distraction. You have to correct the deformity on the medial side and at the same time elongate the foot on the lateral side so that there may not be crushing of the bones on the lateral side and you achieve lengthening of the foot. So this is how this CTV frame is made, and we do the distraction protocol. That is, first we correct the deformity on the table, not full correction but whatever we can achieve easily, and then made these corrections anteriorly, tibio, metatarsal, and with the distractor on the medial and the lateral and the posterior side. And after 5 to 7 days, once the edema has subsided and the child has become comfortable with the fixator, then start the distraction regime. It should be 1 millimeter per day on the medial side and 0.5 millimeter on the lateral side. Start the distraction simultaneously on the medial and the lateral side. After you have corrected the varus deformity of the forefoot and inversion deformity of the forefoot, then start lengthening the TA by doing the distraction after 2 to 3 weeks. The same regime is here also. On the medial side we do 1 millimeter per day and on the lateral side 0.5 millimeter per day. By this the varus of the heel is also corrected. And once this is inversion and the varus of the forefoot and the hind foot is corrected, then simultaneously every week or so we loosen these link joints and the stress on the anterior part of the ankle joint is loosened, and we just bring the foot into dorsiflexion, but it will not be forcefully. Let the foot come of its own into corrected position gradually. It should not be forceful. And so every week we have to correct the dorsiflexion. So all the three deformities, we start correction simultaneously. But first 2 weeks we do not distract posteriorly. That's about the regime and about the care of this assembly. Because the child is small and he is irritable in the first week, we should always protect the his other limb or other parts of the body. These all K wires should be protected with the knobs, and this assembly should be in a cardboard protection so that the child may not get the injuries on his other foot or leg or other parts of the body, or the mother may not get injured by the irritable child. So this is regarding the assembly. I think if you have any queries regarding it, you can ask. Do you want to do the hands-on on this? Come then to the table.